Hi, I'm AJ Smith, Senior Product Marketing Manager on the Microsoft 365 Security Team, and I want to give you a quick tour of Microsoft Secure Score. So first, how do you get to Microsoft Secure Score? Well, there's two places you can go. First is if you go to the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center, you'll find a widget right on the homepage that says Microsoft Secure Score. And I can click on the link that says Microsoft Secure Score to take me directly to that page. You can also just go directly to securescore.microsoft.com and log in with your admin credentials, and you'll see this experience, and you'll land right on the dashboard. So right at the top, you'll see your Microsoft Secure Score, and you have a numerator and a denominator. Your numerator, in this case in my tenant, is 761, and I get these points based on the security controls I've enabled for Office 365 and Windows. My denominator is 1,189 and is made up of all the points that I could potentially obtain based on the security features that I own. So if you own Microsoft 365 E3, you'll have a different denominator than you would if you had Microsoft 365 E5. Now the score is calculated every day, and that's what you see to the right of your actual score. This is the last date the score was calculated. And it gets calculated every single night at roughly 1 a.m. Pacific time. Now this date is obviously not today's date because today is not done. You can still act to improve your score, and that's why the date we show you is of the previous day. So it's great that you have a score, but a lot of organizations want to understand how their score compares with other organizations. So what we did is create an option for you to compare your score and benchmark yourself against those other organizations. So as you can see here, I have two extra averages that we can compare you against. The first is the Office 365 average score. And this is made up of every single Office 365 tenant. We take their score and divide it by the number of Office 365 tenants. And that score is currently 30. Now, this might seem like a really small number, but realize that in Office 365, we have tenants of all sizes, from the smallest of small businesses to the largest of largest enterprises. And remember that security is looked at differently in small businesses versus large enterprises. And we have a lot of small businesses that use Office 365. Now, some organizations told us that, you know, this was great, but they wanted to better understand what their score compared against to other organizations that were of similar size. So we added in the Office 365 seat size average score. The seat size average score compares your organization and how many active seats you have against other similarly sized organizations. In this tenant here, I have 25 seats. Well, that puts me in the group of organizations that have between 6 and 99 seats, and that average is 32. Now coming soon, we're going to add in an industry average, because we've heard a lot of organizations ask us for, you know, it's great that I have a seat size average, but I want to compare myself against other organizations that are in the same industry. For example, if I'm in financial services, I want to see an average just for other financial services customers. So what we're going to do is bring in that average, and that will be calculated based on how you self-select your industry in the Security Compliance Center under the Service Assurance page. So now that you can compare yourself, you probably want to understand how you can actually increase your score. And we give you a way to do that through this widget here called Take Action and Improve Your Office 365 Secure Score. So you'll notice that I have a target score of 408. So this is the score I'm trying to reach. And to get there, I have to take 13 actions. But I can use this slider bar here to decrease my target score and go from a more balanced approach to a basic approach. And you'll notice that the number of actions in the queue decrease. And or I can move the slider bar to the right and increase the number of actions, but take a more aggressive approach. Move the slider, let's say I want to reach that 408 number again. I can see that there are 13 actions in the queue that I need to take to get to this score of 408. So you notice like the first thing at the top of the list is enable MFA for all global admins. It's a great thing to do. It helps you better protect your tenant. It's one of the most effective things that you should do. Second in the list is enable MFA for all users. Again, another great action that you should look at. But 13 actions is a lot to do for some organizations. And they want to better understand, how can I make this a little bit easier to digest? So what we did is we built a filter so that you can easily go in and say, only show me things that maybe affect accounts. So which actions will take effect on my user accounts? Which ones will take effect on data or devices? Or which actions have a low user impact or implementation cost, right? Is it something that's a relatively low cost or a medium cost? So in this case, let's take a look at only items that have a low user impact. And you'll notice that the actions in the queue decrease all the way down to 7. And right at the top of the list is still enable MFA for all admins because it's a low user impact piece. But you'll notice that MFA for users disappears because that's not low impact. That's a much bigger impact than just the few admins that you have inside your organization. Now you'll also notice inside of my actions list is that there are some that say not scored. These not scored items just mean that we have not wired up the telemetry for us to understand if you've enabled this actual control. It doesn't mean you shouldn't do the control. You should still go ahead and enable it and take that action. And once we wire that control up for telemetry, then we'll automatically give you those points. So that's the high-level view of the Secure Score dashboard. Check out our other videos on how to use Microsoft Secure Score to help you enable security controls, understand how your score is progressing over time, and how to use the Secure Score API. Thanks for watching.